The first part of security planning is to sort of do an inventory of our assets. What is that we have which is of value? And something that is of value, of course, has to, there has to be some risk to it. So there has to be a threat. That is the source of that risk that is faced by this particular asset. So the services, the software, the hardware, these are the assets that we have, and we have to concern ourselves about securing them. So when you think about cybersecurity and planning for it, of course, you have to worry about all these assets, or the list of what needs to be secured has to include all these. When you talk about the software, so this is sort of the hardware. When it comes to software, we're running operating systems on these servers or laptops or mobile devices. The databases that store large amounts of data, perhaps. The services that are talking about, the applications actually we have on these devices. Again, when it comes to software and services, we have to worry about that. And of course, the databases or the file systems, they're storing lots of data, either structured data or in files. Some of that data is going to be sensitive. Some of it could be highly sensitive. It could be your intellectual property. You could be in employee records and things like that. So, of course, we have to say where this data resides, what kind of database, which server, and are we securing the server, the database, and the data that's stored in it. And whenever you talk about assets and securing them from whom? Are we concerned about external attackers or hackers? And, you know, they could be cyber criminals. They could be motivated for some other reason. Hacktivists, for example, activists perhaps don't like you or your business or whatever it is. So is it remote hackers that concern us when it comes to securing all these assets that we're talking about? Or it's insiders, it's employees within the organization.